Welcome. In this video, we'll explore how accurate and reliable data is crucial in supporting disaster declaration requests. We will cover some key topics, including what is data and why is using it important? How is data used during the initial damage assessments and preliminary damage assessment process? Where can SLTTs find and access FEMA data? Where can SLTTs find and access data from federal and non-governmental sources? What tools are available to find and document data? Where can I learn more? What is data and why is it important to disaster recovery efforts? FEMA defines data as recorded information regardless of form or media on which the data is recorded. Data can take many forms, from interviews with survivors in disaster impacted areas to aerial imagery and geospatial data sets. Measuring disaster impact isn't always as simple as it seems. Damage can be hidden and costly. That's why the federal government, states, local governments, tribal nations, and territories use data to respond and help communities recover. How is data used during preliminary damage assessments? When a disaster incident occurs, local, territorial governments, and tribal nations work to understand its impact by collecting information from affected communities. They use an initial damage assessment, or IDA, to gather this data. The information collected during initial damage assessments must meet certain criteria. It has to be verifiable and well documented. It must be consistently categorized using FEMA's degrees of damage. The information must be supported by multiple sources, such as GIS mapping, aerial imagery, or direct site assessments. Lastly, the information has to be properly formatted to align with FEMA's declaration factors. FEMA provides templates, checklists, and tools that can help collect and share data with the federal government. After the initial damage assessments are complete, they are sent to state, tribal nation, and/or territorial officials for review. If the disaster is beyond the capacity of the impacted jurisdiction, state, tribal nation, and/or territorial officials may submit a request for a joint preliminary damage assessment to their regional FEMA office. This request can be made using the PDA request letter template located on FEMA's preliminary damage assessment website. FEMA uses the preliminary damage assessment process, or PDA, to validate the data submitted as part of the state, tribal nation, and/or territory's request by checking the accuracy of the information. The joint PDA team, made up of federal, state, tribal nation, and/or territory representatives, reviews the data together. The validated data is then used to support government requests for disaster declarations. The information collected during the PDA must meet certain criteria. It must be validated information collected during the initial damage assessments. The reviewed information and preliminary damage assessments must be conducted together. The information must be used to inform requests for a presidential disaster declaration, which makes supplemental federal disaster funding available. Once the joint PDA is complete, the state, tribal nation, and/or territory may request a presidential disaster declaration, which makes supplemental disaster funding available from the federal government. Accurate and consistent reporting helps FEMA verify damage and recommend the right assistance. Incomplete or inconsistent data can delay the declaration process or limit available aid. FEMA offers various resources to help SLTT governments gather and analyze disaster data. FEMA regional offices provide specialists, data sets, and other tools to assist with finding and using data. These resources support states, local governments, tribal nations, and territories even before a joint PDA request is made. FEMA created digital damage survey templates for both individual assistance and public assistance to help state, local, tribal nation, and territorial partners use during the initial damage assessment process. Using these templates can help ensure that jurisdictions identify damage and collect information that FEMA will need to validate the damage during the joint PDA process. There are also paper survey templates called street sheets that can be printed and used. Additionally, FEMA provides initial damage assessment checklists for both public assistance and individual assistance. These checklists guide partners to the information most helpful for their disaster declaration requests. FEMA's YouTube channel offers videos like this one, providing overviews, key information, and resources in short, easy-to-understand formats for various audiences. FEMA also maintains a repository of past disaster declarations, which can help states, tribal nations, and territories find information on past disasters to support their declaration requests. For public assistance applicants, the FEMA Public Assistance Grants Portal simplifies the process of submitting damage assessments and tracking application statuses. For information on FEMA's Public Assistance Grants Portal, visit FEMA's YouTube channel and watch the video, Grants Portal, I'm Logged In, Now What? FEMA also provides geospatial and analytical tools to support damage assessments. The FEMA Geospatial Resource Center offers disaster impact data, interactive maps, and other tools to help assess affected areas. FEMA's Flood Map Service Center offers flood maps by entering an address, place, or coordinates. This information is continually updated to provide the most current information. In addition to FEMA's resources, SLTT governments should use other credible data sources to support their disaster declaration requests. State and local emergency management agencies collect real-time impact data to help local jurisdictions to identify PDA findings. State, local, and tribal nation officials, along with FEMA, then validate the data. For environmental and weather-related disasters, agencies such as the U.S. Geological Survey and the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, or NOAA, provide critical data on flooding, earthquakes, hurricanes, and other hazards. Census.gov can provide important information about demographics, income levels, and other features of impacted communities that can support the disaster declaration request. The Small Business Administration, Bureau of Labor Statistics, and the Census Bureau can provide information about economic data such as employment, businesses, and more. Other federal agencies such as the Bureau of Indian Affairs, U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, U.S. Department of Agriculture, and the Federal Highway Administration can provide important demographic, infrastructure, and labor reports that are updated regularly. Additionally, organizations such as Voluntary Organizations Active in Disaster, or VOADs, track community needs and may offer insights into volunteer agency activities. Where can I learn more? FEMA provides a range of helpful resources with additional information on using data to support disaster declaration requests. For tribal governments, the Tribal Declarations Interim Guidance offers additional considerations for documenting damage and requesting federal assistance. The Preliminary Damage Assessment Guide and Pocket Guide offer detailed guidance on data collection and assessment procedures. The Public Assistance Program and Policy Guide and the Individual Assistance Program and Policy Guide outline the specific data requirements for public assistance and individual assistance requests. These resources, along with training materials, templates, and best practices, are available on FEMA's website under the Preliminary Damage Assessment section. Thanks for watching this overview of using data to support disaster declaration requests. For more information, please visit the FEMA Preliminary Damage Assessment website at FEMA.gov/PDA.